Gleason's Q is Sonic Wave slash Resonating Strike. It is a dash and skill shot. Here's an example of me using it through a wall on a vein, and I end up getting an early kill. Gleason's W safeguard slash Iron Will gives you a shield and spell vamp and allows you to dash nearby wards or friendly units. Here's an example of me juking out an entire team with it, and great ward placement. Dodge the Lux Laser, and I managed to make it with my life. Here's a Vayne, who's extremely fed. Notice how I use the walls to my advantage, because both my dashes go through the walls. It's a great example of both Q and W with their finest juking abilities. Gleason's E reveals stealth units and slows enemies, doesn't need to be explained very much. His ultimate is Dragon Rage, the kick, sends enemies flying backwards and knocks up enemies, does good damage. Here's an example of me using it to exclude Sona from a fight away from her AD carry, allowing me to get a kill on Vayne and live. Here's my beginning route as Lee Sin. I start with a Doran's Ring. My routes always change as Lee Sin, but this is a particular one I like a lot. Use your passive effectively. Those two hits after you use an ability really make your juggling a lot easier. If you ever see a ganking ability, you can gank now, but in this case I didn't, so I went and I grabbed golems, I got my bottom lane so I could pull them, and then I go for a gank. Here I come on this Alistair and Ahri. I pop my ghost, and I see Alistair, I pop Splash. He's a pretty good heal, so he's probably trying to stay in lane. I see that. I initiate with my E slow, and finish with my Q. And grab first blood. Here I find a low health Teemo and a really cocky gangplank. I managed to get a double kill up top just from Map Awareness. Map Awareness is key as Lee Sin. Well, Jason gangplank tries to slow him with red buff, but I ends up taking a couple turret shots and he thinks he can take me with his crits and his oranges. Here's an example of a level 1 team fight as Lee Sin. You are extremely strong. Here they don't focus me, which is really stupid, and I managed to do a ton of damage to their team in all. They come to gank me at red. Caitlyn gets caught. Their idiot Tryndamere flashes in. He gets killed almost instantly. We get first blood, which is huge in level 1 fights, and we proceed to wreck their team for a 3-3 exchange. Last two managed to get away, but they have both popped their summoners, which will come back to haunt them later in this clip, these clips. So after that level 1 team fight, I grab my beginning red. I usually start with my Doran's Ring, and I come gank mid. I see Victor already. I know Victor already used his flash through the team fight, and here I come. I come over here to see if I can get a kill on this Cho'Gath, but there's no way I can do it, so I come to meet at his blue and find Nocturne, who recently popped his flash. And I release it as an amazing counter jungler. I win, finish with my Q. It's an example of counter jungling early as Lee Sin. We get top and mid to come. into their blue, and we wait out their jungler, see if we can bait if there anybody in. And Caitlyn falls for it. This is a risky strategy, but the reward is good if it works. I get first blood. I hope somebody cares. When the blood dries in my veins and my heart feels no more pain, I know I'll be on my way. Here's another clip of me ganking an Ahri after I get my red. At least an extremely strong level 2 ganker with a cat closer and a slow. After that, I'm able to buy wards and boots, and I go to pay removal visit in this jungle after getting blue for experience. Usually get the second blue away. Slow-mo this, just counter jungling at its finest. Try to use your Q as a finisher because it does 10% of their missing health, and does great. It's just a great finisher overall. It does great damage. Here's a sort of outdated Lee Sin jungle route. I start with Vampiric Scepter and go for more sustained jungling instead of early ganking and recklessness. I come to annoy this Karthus at mid. It's really nice to get early lane dominance. No man doesn't have to get a kill for a gank to work out. All you gotta do is get pop a summoner. And that's exactly what we do. After dropping out top, I come right back mid, and we manage to pick up first blood here. I put a nice Q. Try to coordinate ganks here. I can see I get Sion to stun him. I Q, do my damage output. And I use my W to get out of there and save me from the turret shots. When the blood dries in my veins and my heart feels no more pain, I know how. After that, I have the gold from first blood experience, first blood assist, which is like 275, and I go back to gank mid and I end up getting a kill. Fuck you. Me finding a move in the jungle, just playing slow-mo. At least it is a god of counter-jungling.